my wrist and these grits trying to whip something new. I am sick of this rampant. So are you. Hold on, switch. Mama, I'm going to introduce my ego. Since the world full of villains, then let's introduce the heroes. We the good guys. No blood on our hands. Hands Tito. She a pack. Finna guarantee though. Move back. Type of view is that on the globe. It's a visionary peeking out the window of my soul. Might just fall back. Lend a helping hand and play my role. You ain't all that. All in the mirror oversold. Call me Reason A, a.k.a. Malcolm XL. That's a big pun. Bigger punishment. I give him hell. Getting done. Keep it blunt enough. You can't. Cough drop, tell them hard for their health.
It's Madden NFL 23, where Mexico City will play host to a different kind of football. It's the Cincinnati Bengals and the Washington Commanders. All that and more coming up next on EA Sports.
From the oldest capital city in the Americas, founded in 1325, EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to Mexico City. Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one between the Cincinnati Bengals and the Washington Commanders. Again, everybody, alongside my partner Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. And Charles, when you and I were going through our final run-throughs at breakfast, we kept thinking tonight we're going to get to see a couple of very good passing offenses.
And we're talking about both sides having multiple receivers that could have an impact on this game. It's not just one guy that's going to make all the plays. If you take him away, maybe number two, number three, they make the big plays that impact who wins the game.
Joey Sly, the kicker, stands ready. And we are underway from Mexico City. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Bengals offense here ready to rock and roll. Joe Burrow is the man at quarterback.
And when you come into the league as the number one guy selected, a lot of hype comes with it. And sometimes that weight can be unbearable. This young man, he took that weight on and handled it as well as you can imagine. And I love his ability to make a second, third reaction play and create downfield.
Here we go.
Right to the air is Burrow. Man open, that's Ja'Marr Chase complete. And they work this well upfield across the 45. 23 yards on the play.
Certainly no settling into the drive there. They came right out on the first play and attacked the middle of the field for a big gainer and a first down.
Here we go. So one play and they're already just shy of midfield.
Here we go.
Now Burrow. And he cannot avoid the pressure as the Washington pass rush gets home. Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game.
And every game we talk about what are going to be the keys as we go into it. Maybe that's a key for their defense today. Pressure the quarterback and make sure you play a good zone defense behind them and they get their first sack of the contest.
Soon this defense will be charging again here. It's second and 15. Another try after the first down sack.
Burrow.
Open receiver. That's Hayden Hurst, the tight end. That'll give him 8 that time. Third and 7 now.
So 7 yards from the first down here as they come up to the line of scrimmage.
On third down, Burrow. Got a man. It's Chase. He completes it. He's going to have the first down, and more than that, touchdown! Ja'Marr Chase, 49 yards! And the Bengals put the Knights' first points on the board as they take the early lead.
Well, fair to say that when you're looking at guys that can run like the wind, you often find them at the wide receiver position, and that was special there.
And that's the kind of play where you have to kind of catch your breath afterwards and just give me a second here, because when he shifted into high gear, he was an absolute blur out there. No substitute for speed. We talk about that all the time. The evidence was right there.
And the top speed he attained there, according to Next Gen Stats, 21.3 miles per hour. Extra point by McPherson, up and good, and it's now a 7-0 game. After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. Taken in at the 3. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. So out comes the Washington offense as they get their first shot. As we get a peek at the number 2 overall pick from the 2016 draft, standing at 6'5", Carson Wentz.
And when you look at him, you see that he's got all the tools you want in a quarterback. The big frame, the quick release, strong arm, has escapability. The issue sometimes, tries to do too much instead of just taking the throws that are available to him, and occasionally turnovers get him into trouble.
Wentz bringing the Commanders up for 1st and 10 at their own 26. Wentz now to throw. That's complete. Terry McLaurin with it. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield. Call that a very strong gain of 24.
Defense gives up a touchdown on the opening drive. Offense, you got to want to get out there and get those points back right now.
And that's a sharp throw there to get this drive off to a good start. Midfield. Here's Wentz. Oh, not sure he saw the linebacker there as that's batted down and incomplete.
This is what defensive coaches ask of their defenders every single ball game. Get a hand on every throw in coverage. They want the deflections. They want the knockaways. Pick it yourself if you can, but at least knock it down and guarantee it's incomplete.
And they'll get this down to around the 47-yard line.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense, because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get it out to your running back, and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
Now the throw on 3rd down, knocked away and incomplete. So on 4th down, Washington going to call on Tress Way to punt it away. Back deep, Trent Taylor. And that'll hit in the end zone. Much too much leg there. That'll be a touchback. Cincinnati coming back onto the field here for their 2nd drive. And they'll be looking to make this a 2-score advantage. Had the touchdown on their 1st drive, Charles. Hey, they can get up 2 scores here in the run. That's a heck of a start.
And not only have they thought about it, I wonder if they visualized it. I remember playing, and they used to turn the lights out in our meeting room and run through a situation like this and say, just think about what it would be like to be up on the road and take the crowd out of it. Maybe they did some of that.
No surprise there. Chase Young wrecks that play with a sack. Well, on that one, they go with a play fake, CD, but I don't think anybody really was fooled. All eyes were fixated on the quarterback, and they got him to the ground.
And to run this play successfully, you've got to make sure that everyone is doing their part. You actually have to sell this play. You've got to sell the run action. Otherwise, why do you stop at the running back? You just run straight for the quarterback and put him on the ground.
After the sack on 1st down, Burrow, and that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's 3rd down.
Here we go.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on 3rd down. Burrow throw. This goes out wide for Mixon. And that's not nearly going to be enough. Stopped at the 22, and he needed plenty more. They do get 7 out of that, but not enough to prevent a 4th down.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the 1st down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they rallied and made the tackle.
Fourth down, out comes the punter, Drew Chrisman. That'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt. And the Commanders will take over with a first and 10. The Commanders going to retake the field for drive number two. Over on the sideline, hoping to hit that reset button between possessions. Last time out, they had to punt it away. This time, hoping to finish this thing off in the end zone. Throwing on first is Wentz. This one complete to Curtis Samuel. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
So they'll come up in Bengals territory now with a first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Wentz. He completes this one to Terry McLaurin. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. It's another first down on what will be a gain of 21 yards.
And when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know, they want to get this man involved as well, and that's what they just did on that play.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Wentz going to throw. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Washington with the football here to begin quarter number two as they go to work on a first and goal. Now Wentz again. Looking for McLaurin, and he's got it. Touchdown, Washington. A 5-yard touchdown catch, and the Commanders are within an extra point of tying up this ball game. On those slants, everything happens so quickly. What makes it work?
The timing between the passer and the receiver. In this case, a slant route, ordinarily it's probably about 3 steps before you go on the slant. In this amount of time, I think it was a 2-step deal. Boom, put his foot in the ground and got inside for the pass.
Got inside for the pass, got inside for the catch and the score. Extra point by Sly is up and good, and we are tied at 7. So that drive, 4 plays. And it's finished off by a Terry McLaurin touchdown. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And they'll put up the stop sign there as his guys will get it at the 25. Now the Cincinnati offense ready to see what they can do here.
These guys definitely hoping for a better showing than their last appearance. They couldn't really even move the football much beyond the shadows of their own goalposts, Charles. We'll see if they can get a better, more sustained drive going here.
Yeah, and every team that we ever talk to says the exact same thing. When you start a drive from that deep in your own territory, the goal is a minimum of at least 2 first downs. Because even if you have to pump then, you change the field position, right? You flip the field a little bit. They didn't get that done. This time they want to string together a nice drive and help themselves out.
So, Charles, no turnovers yet for this offense, but those sacks now, they're starting to pile up.
And one thing usually leads to another because they've got to figure out how the offensive line and everyone else involved in protection can keep their quarterback upright and allow him a chance to throw the ball downfield.
On one, ready?
Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. Burrow going to give this to Mixon. No gain on the play this time, and it'll be a third and long situation coming up. Burrow looking to pass. And that will be in.
incomplete.
Like what I see so far out of this defense, because they've been showing their best coverages on third down. So far, only allowed one conversion on a handful of attempts. One area of their game plan that they've executed to perfection.
And on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. It'll be a 51-yard punt that time. And it will be Washington football now with a first and 10. Carson Wentz leading the Commander offense back to the field. And he had the touchdown on the last drive, also 4 for 4. Very, very effective. What does he need to do to translate that forward into this drive?
Not think that what he saw in coverages last time is exactly what he's going to get again. He's got to play ahead and start thinking to himself, okay, we just did that. What are they going to take away now? What do we go to as a counter? And continue to encourage his offensive line to continue to give him time.
They were really good on the last drive. Wentz will try again on second down. That's complete to his receiver, McLaurin. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. It's a gain of 34. But one thing's for sure, they're going to have to come up with something at halftime, because he is absolutely roasting them right now.
They're going to go through the whole litany of things, changing coverages, you know, what are we going to do, put a man on him. The big thing to me is treat it like a good pitcher treats pitching a game. Change your timing, change your location. So sometimes you're up on him, sometimes you're back. Just change up the looks that he sees and make him just a little bit more hesitant.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. To throw is Wentz. And he knocks the ball away and it falls incomplete.
He didn't just deny a big throw there. He brought that one up in the red zone. An excellent play. One that may help save points on the board when this drive is over.
Back to the air on second down. Wentz looking for McLaurin, and he's got him. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Bengals' 17-yard line. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there, because it's zone coverage, so timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Into the red zone, Wentz. And a dangerous throw there, incomplete. He threw that into coverage. It was nearly intercepted.
But there's an incompletion, partner, and the struggles through the air continue, because so far their lack of passing production has led to a lack of points.
To throw again on second down. Wentz, quick slant, Dotson. And the Commanders are going to have a first and goal coming up as the tackle made at the 3-yard line.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game, because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
We've hit the 2-minute mark of the first half. All knotted up, it's 7. Again, they'll throw with Wentz. A quick throw there, going to be batted away and incomplete.
Coaches talk about it all the time. Players talk about it as well. Excellent job staying disciplined in coverage and making that stop. Inside the red zone, every stop like that could be preventing a possible touchdown.
Looking for McLaurin, and he's got it. Touchdown, Washington. Carson Wentz with 2 first-half touchdown passes. And the Commanders have taken the lead. CD, for them, this has just been an offensive explosion here in the second quarter.
Yeah, held scoreless in the first quarter. Now they find the end zone again here in the second. Sometimes you just have to have some patience. A lot of people think it's always an adjustment. You have to change what you're doing. Sometimes you just have to do your game plan just a little bit better. And I think that's part of what we're seeing here.
So with a missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off.
And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25. So now the Bengal offensive unit back out onto the field. As we eat closer and closer to intermission, Charles, remember last time out they punted. They would love to get points here, especially if this is going to be their final possession of the first half.
Yeah, and this is what close games feel like because the pressure is on both sides, but sometimes the pressure is a little bit higher on the team with the slight edge because they're trying to hold on to that, trying to increase it. Let's see how this one continues.
Now the Bengals urging everybody to get back to the line of scrimmage. Meanwhile, Burrow's throw into the hands of Boyd. First down now, but that clock rolling. Now it's Burrow. Throw left side complete to Chase. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. Calling a gain of 6 on the play, and that's going to bring up second down.
And we've seen him have success earlier on with the ball in his hands because he is a get it in space and make a play kind of a receiver. But that time, they closed on him quickly and held him to a short gain.
4 yards remain for second down. Here's Burrow. That one taken in by T. Higgins. And they're going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at Washington's 32-yard line. A good pickup there, 22. Charles, to move the chains that time, they had to complete it into double coverage, and they got it done.
And it's never easy overcoming multiple defenders, but he sure made it look simple. Found the right spot to exploit and won his one-on-two matchup.
Here we go.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. To the air again, Burrow. And this one incomplete, threw it down at the feet of his receiver.
And not a common sight, at least on this drive. A momentary setback, though, for this passing game. It has been moving well this series. Good thing for them, though. Still two more downs to connect and try to pick up another first down.
And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. The Bengals going to use the second of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. So it's first and goal and a great opportunity to get that lead back before the break. Now Burrow. And that is caught. He's got it for the Bengal touchdown. Joe Mixon, a 5-yard touchdown. And the Bengals are an extra point away from moving out in front in the final minute of the half. Well, he wasn't the guy they were initially going for, but after going through the progressions, it worked.
When you have plenty of people who can catch the football, you don't always have to go to your primary target, and sometimes that target is actually covered. Nice job coming off of that and getting it to someone who was open.
And the man out of the backfield gets in for the score. Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And that will give him the lead here as we get on towards halftime. After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. Taken at the goal line. And he won't quite make it to the 25. There's Terry McLaurin, such an exciting pass catcher as this offense comes out for their next drive. Previous series, definitely a focal point. 3 catches, the touchdown grab. As a DB, your former DB, is there a number of catches on a drive you're like, oh, he got the best of us?
I'm not sure there's a number, but there's a great feel. And what he did on the last drive, yeah.
Especially with the touchdown.
Yes.
You're never happy.
You're exactly right. The way he capped it off. So you feel that at the sideline, and now you're looking at your buddies and saying, okay, what are we going to do to take things away from him? Because I'm not sure the other guys can make those sort of plays. So let's make sure that we don't let him get going again.
23 yards the pickup there.
That was good protection there. No, that was great protection there because it allowed him to lock in on his receiver. Although I think he was looking for his tight end on the corner route all the way. Nice connection there for a really nice game.
And yet again, it's McLaurin. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30.
So we have reached halftime here, and it's the visiting Bengals out in front as we send you up to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman and our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. Back to you guys in a bit. But first, we welcome everyone to our EA Sports Halftime Report. First, though, time for a check of the next-gen stats from that first half for Cincinnati. And their passing game has been the reason why they lead thus far. They've had great success moving the ball through two quarters of play. Meanwhile, for Washington, they were even better throwing the football. Lots of open receivers to choose from, and you can bet that'll continue to be a focus in the second half. These two teams going through their final halftime adjustments, probably trying to get some oxygen as well. And for the call of the second half, let's get you back down to Mexico City and Brandon God.
Okay, Coach, yeah, adjustments likely going to play a big role in this third quarter in what's been a tight contest so far. The Washington offense ready to go to begin the third quarter. This offense, Charles, had a strong first half throwing the football, at least in terms of yardage, but that hasn't translated so far on the scoreboard as they begin the third quarter here, trailing and looking for a little momentum.
Yeah, you're right about that because, you know, let's face it, in the first half, most of their focus was in the passing game, and to their credit, resulted in a healthy amount of yardage. So I would think that at halftime, they're going to anticipate that defense loosening up a little bit to try and cover the passing lanes. They've got to get the running game going, and there should be some gaps to run through now.
A good pickup there, 26 yards.
Boy, a lot of moving parts on this play, but what a nice design to leak the running back out to the left and send him down the field. And a good job spotting him and hitting him for a big play.
So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. Now Wentz. And incomplete, he dropped it. Maybe a rookie mistake there, second down.
After watching him drop that slant, I can hear my old coach's voice ringing in my ears right now. You can't run with the ball until you catch it. Trying to get those rack yards before he secured it.
On second and 10, Wentz, he's got it to Gibson. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Bengals 33. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains.
And they certainly had success throughout this contest getting him the ball in the passing game. And there he picks up another first down. Whatever they saw going into this one, they've been able to capitalize on it, and no adjustment has been made to take it away.
So they'll come up in Bengals territory now with a first and 10 down at the 33. Again, it's Wentz. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. 23 yards, the final tally. He's certainly been a huge factor in this one. He's got the two touchdowns to his credit. Now they look to him again. He picks up the first.
Yeah, I can hear everyone saying, well, why don't you cover him, double him, triple him, do what you have to do. But sometimes they get locked into such a groove and such a connection, it doesn't matter how many guys are in his area.
He certainly looks to be in that groove right now. Now a first and 10 at the 11.
We're good. Stop.
Working from the gun, Wentz. He's got it. Touchdown, Commanders. Three touchdown passes now for Carson Wentz. And the Commanders have retaken a third quarter lead. So, Charles, they had him double covered in the end zone. It still was not enough.
I wonder if they're thinking to themselves now, two didn't work. Do we go for three guys on him next time? Because he fought through all that extra attention. Got himself into a great position where his quarterback felt confident enough to challenge the coverage and throw it his way. What a big-time play right there, both by the quarterback trusting it and by him going up and getting it.
And he is not going to make it to the goal line, so the defense holds, and this remains a five-point game.
I don't know about you, but I can't wait for a few years of two-point tries and see what the data tells us, because a lot of teams want to throw the ball in this situation, this time unsuccessfully. I just wonder if maybe running the ball might be the way to go.
With it moved up from the three to the two, you would think maybe a few more attempts at running.
I think stats over time may bear out that running the ball will at least be the equal of throwing it in that situation.
Joey Sly now to kick off after the touchdown. And and no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback. So here are the Bengals now as they get their first possession of this second half. And Charles, it feels like we're set up for a good second half here. Came out of the locker room, one score game. Now the lead has already changed hands. Well, this offense, they've got an opportunity right now to take that lead right back.
Yeah, and it feels like you're going back and forth almost a little bit like a tennis match, right? And we're just already, you know, our heads just keep moving. Which side has it? Which side's going to score? How are they going to go out doing it? A little bit of a challenge for each side trying to match each other.
And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. They may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. Now it's Burrow. That's going to be complete on the sideline, but, you know, that throw left him no room to run, and the good footwork nearly all for naught. From the 44, Burrow, and his throw is going to be incomplete. T. Higgins is the intended target, and it's third down.
That was well defended. They clamped down on every available receiver. Just got to give the win to the defense on that snap.
Got a man. It's Chase. He completes it. And he is going to have a Bengals first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. If you're going to blitz, likely going to leave you in man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is, because just about any offense that has an elite receiver, if you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to him. Even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is before the defender does.
In Washington territory now, here's first and 10 at the 46. They're passing here, Joe Burrow. Throw right side, pulled in by Higgins. And the tackle going to be made at the 38.
Here we go.
3 yards remain for second down. Burrow going to fake to mix it and now look to throw. Oh, the Commanders are going to get there as he's taken down. That's Daron Payne with a sack that time.
And this dominant defensive performance continued on that play. This poor quarterback has now received the protection he needs and has had to pick himself up off the turf far too often.
Here we go.
Now play number 7 of this drive, but it's a tough 3rd and 9. Out of the gun, it's Burrow. He's going to have the hook up here to Chase. And they're going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at Washington's 34-yard line. The Bengals passing game finding a rhythm. They've got another first.
That's the third time on this drive that these two have connected with each other. They've got a real rapport going. And right now, it's paying off with big chunks of yardage, as shown by that last play.
From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10. Burrow will throw. A quick throw, knocked away, and incomplete.
Yeah, their backs up against the wall a little bit, and they come through by forcing an incompletion. Now they've got to continue to ratchet up the intensity a couple more times and get off the field before giving up any more yardage.
And this time he's going backwards. So after the no gain on the last attempt, here they get him behind the line.
Here we go.
And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Back now in Mexico City. The offense on third down tonight, they've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This is 3rd down and 12. Open man, it's complete to Higgins. And they're going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at Washington's 17-yard line. Nice 3rd down conversion at even 20 yards.
And here we are in the 4th quarter, partner, and watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed too.
on gun.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. This is caught. And the Bengals are looking at first and goal as he's tackled all the way down at the 2-yard line. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
Here we go.
Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown, and that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. Look at this, a tight end carry. And he gets halfway there, down to the one-yard line. Two of their three red zone trips so far, they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on second and goal. They go play action with Burrow. Under pressure, down he goes. Sacked at the 10. The coverage good, the pressure good, leads to the sack. And it's third and goal now.
Oh man, it's been a rough night for that offensive line, and it's only getting rougher. Five sacks now that they've given up in this contest so far. It feels like the witching hour out here, doesn't it?
Okay, stupid question. What's the witching hour?
Yeah, the witching hour. That's when everything goes haywire late at night.
For the lead, here's third and goal.
11 mighty, 11, 11, 11, MP, 11, 11, left.
Burrow looking to pass. And it's intercepted at the goal line. And the Commanders are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20. So a good drive with a bad ending, Charles. They move it down the field well. Cannot finish it off, though, as it's intercepted in the end zone.
Deflating, that has got to be the word here because they were sharp in moving it down the field. But sometimes you start thinking like a touchdown is a given. And it doesn't always work out that way as we saw there.
The Commanders' offense returning to the field. Another important fourth quarter series coming up. That last INT helping to maintain their slim advantage. Wentz bringing the Commanders up for first and 10 at the 20. So after the INT, here's Wentz. This to McLaurin out on the left side. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. 15 yards is the pickup there, and the drive starting very nicely. First down.
Well, it may seem a little unorthodox to some people. Got the lead, fourth quarter, yet he's still firing away. I think he believes that's the best way to go ahead and win the game.
Yeah, a lot of coaches say, let's just run the football, be conservative. He's sticking to his game plan.
No, that is his game, and that's what they're going to ride.
They're not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Now Wentz. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Well, these defensive coaches, they sure like what they've got in this rookie corner. And with good reason, as you saw there.
It only cost him a day two pick, and a lot of people thought he had first-round ability. But when he was available on draft night, that was one where you didn't need the full time to make the selection. You call that pick in early, and he shows why he was so coveted with that interception there.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Got a man open. It's Chase. And the tackle going to be made at the 38.
Here we go.
Fourth quarter. Down to the final 2 minutes. And we've got a one-score game. So the Bengals in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They come up on a second down now in a game that looks like it's going to go down to the wire. To throw, Burrow. Oh, no, he lost the football. And it's Washington that scoops it up. And they are going to set up shop at the 32-yard line.
Well, that simply is a missed opportunity. They're in position. If they take the ball downfield and score, they've got a chance to win the game. Instead, they cough it up. I don't think next week at practice is going to be a whole lot of fun for him.
On the other side, no bigger time to force a turnover when you've got that small lead.
Yeah, and when you look at it from the offense's perspective, taking care of the ball is so important. I know they're going to have all kind of ball security drills in practice all next week.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. And Wentz not going to take the snap here. Instead, he turns and calls a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages.
Let's go.
They'll start on the ground with Gibson. And now with 1:52 to go, we get another pause in the action. A timeout here defensively. So second and 9, and you'd have to figure just about all 11 probably crashing the line here. Wentz to throw. Throw right side, taken in by Gibson. The Bengals going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. And a nickel look here for the Bengals as they try to defend this on third. To throw is Wentz. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Back to throw. Wentz. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
It's another zone defense. It looks like it's open for possibilities, but they did a nice job patrolling the middle of the field and forcing an incompletion.
Wentz to throw. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete.
Well, he's smart enough to avoid the taunting rule, but I'm guaranteeing he quietly has told them, you might want to stop coming after me downfield because I just broke up another pass and took away a big shot that you were trying to succeed with.
Thomas brings it in. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Bengals' 34-yard line. 21 yards there on third down.
It's a nice zone breaker right there. Take the tight end, move him out to the slot, then have him run a corner route versus the zone coverage, which means he's going to be behind the shallow coverage and ahead of the deep coverage, put the ball right on him.
Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Now Wentz. And he completes this one to Terry McLaurin. And they're going to get this down inside the 20.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down. Stomp down. How about that? Back-to-back completions. They are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Oh, look at this. Wentz going to throw. Throwing it Terry McLaurin's way again, and he's got it. And the Commanders are going to have a first and goal coming up as the tackle made at the 3-yard line.
And these guys certainly not hiding what their intention is. They're absolutely showing it. They're definitely not going to sit on this lead here in the fourth quarter.
It's first and goal and a late touchdown at this stage. Could officially salt this one away. Wentz to throw again. And this is caught. And that could seal it. It's a touchdown. So a little icing on the cake there before the clock hits all zeros.
What a way to finish things off. Exactly what you want. Not much time and a touchdown to put things away.
Now Joey Sly for the point after. He missed one earlier, remember, but this time he gets it to go. So that drive consumes 9 plays all told. And it's finished off by a Terry McLaurin touchdown. Joey Sly now to kick off after the touchdown. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback.
On one, ready?
The Bengals drive about to get going. This is just an exercise in futility. Do you even bother running a play here offensively?
I wouldn't, because now is not going to erase what's happened during the game. So after it's over, you're going to go to the film, find out where the game was really lost. But this is not a situation now where you're going to make up for anything.
We'll see what they do here. Well, that second half, Charles, a little bit different from the first. Not only did we have the lead change after intermission, but they were able to pitch the shutout in the second half and get an impressive victory.
And what's the old expression? That's not quite how I saw it playing out in my head. You know they didn't expect this at all. As you mentioned, went into the half with the lead. Losing the game is one thing. Getting shut out in the second half, that's a surprise.